y'all, and welcome to today's video. This is going to be my monthly favorites, hate it's. This is where I sit down and I review products for y'all. Products I love, hate, feel indifferent about, products that were good but aren't favorites. Everything I've been trying out, I want to give y'all full reviews. That's what we're doing today. Full product reviews. Some of these things, so bad. I can't wait to share my thoughts. If you are new here, hey, my name is Heather and makeup makes me happy. Here at my channel, we don't try to be perfect. We just want to have a good time with our makeup, whatever that means. Shimmer, glitter, all the product reviews, we are here for it. So if that sounds good to you, I do hope that you will subscribe before you leave today because I upload lots of new videos every single week and we just want to have fun. We want to have fun here. I have a lot of thoughts to share though, so let's jump into it. Hey y'all, all of the products I'm going to talk about today, I either have YouTube videos using those products, I have Instagram videos using those products, and I always tell y'all when I'm trying something new that I will follow up with a review after I really have my full thoughts, especially when I do like first impression videos. I like to follow up and let you know what I think after some time has passed. So that's what we're gonna do today. I do have a lot of things to start with, but let's start with the worst makeup product I have ever tried in my life. Should we do that first? Listen, this Flower Beauty Stellar Prismatic Highlighter Illuminator is the worst thing I have ever tried in my life. I did a video with this. This is why I bought this product. Cream powder hybrid texture. Let me read that again. It says it on the product. Cream powder hybrid texture. You can go watch the video if you want to see a swatch and see me apply this. I'm not going to open it because I'm pretty sure there's like some type of evil presence living inside of this that's just out to get me. Okay? This is the driest formula. Like literally I touch it and it feels scratchy. It is glitter. It is that horrible Christmas glitter. You know when you're like digging through Christmas ornaments and you're like, there are these broken ornaments at the bottom and there's just this glitter everywhere. That's this highlighter. It is terrible. And listen, some of y'all really hate me because the amount of comments I got on that video saying, try it on your eyes. And I'm like, y'all really want me to go blind? I thought we were friends here. I thought we were all friends. Y'all really want me to put this ugly chunky glitter on my eyes? I don't understand. I love glitter. Listen, I love glitter so much. Not this. Not this. This is horrible. I cannot wait to declutter this. I'm not even going to pass it on to somebody else. I'm going to throw it away. I personally don't have anybody that I hate enough to give this to. It's terrible. It's terrible. Should we move on to something happy now? Let me tell you, normally I do a eyeshadow palette ranking video every month where I rank my eyeshadow palettes kind of from best to worst or from really good to best, but I decided I would go ahead and talk about how good this palette is in today's video. This is the Flower Beauty Desert Lights. So I did a video where like this was the worst thing ever and this was amazing. This is so beautiful. This, I decided that I would review a couple of palettes in this video. One, I have a palette that's older, I'll say older, and then I have this palette and another that's all shimmers and they're smaller palettes. So I decided that I'd go ahead and give y'all my thoughts here. Now, I'm wearing this shade right here on my inner corner. This is just a beautiful palette. Honestly, if you were looking for some out of this world shimmery shadows, this palette is so good. It was recently on sale at Ulta Beauty for like $12, which I feel like is just an amazing price point. Everything I can link down below for y'all, I will have linked, but look at that. It's just so beautiful. This is amazing. The sister palette to this, Jungle Lights, which is more colorful, is also amazing. I bought that last year and I love it. The pan size is huge and the payoff of these shadows is just amazing. In the video I did with this, I showed you how to get an all shimmer look. So if you're interested in that, definitely check the video out. I will try to link as many videos as I can down below in case you're curious. But I love this palette. This is so amazing. Okay, since I talked about that palette, I also wanted to mention the Flare Collection Remixed Pressed Pigment Palette. This is from It's Bell. I decided to review this here instead of my palette ranking because, again, we have an all shimmery duochrome or sparkle shade palette. This shade is the shade that I have on my eyes today. I actually have it mixed with the Blend Bunny Surge palette. I used mattes from that palette and then put this shade all over the lid and I just love it. This is so amazing. This shade right here shifts from like a gold to a pink. It's a beautiful duochrome shade. I do have a video up eye swatching this palette in case you're like, you know what, I want to see it all in action. You can definitely check that out. There's just some really pretty shades. If you like lots of shifty shades like I do, I mean, I just love it. I have this palette. I have the other palette they did. Alien Cosmetics has a large, like all duochrome palette too that I love, and I think this one's really good. My code with It's Bell, I have an affiliate code, it's Heather. If you want to save money at checkout, I had just shared on my community tab not long ago because they opened up a second round of orders, but I really love all shimmery, all sparkly palettes. I think they're so fun and they can just add so much. So yeah, after I've been playing with that for a lot more, I wanted just to follow up and let y'all know that yes, it is so good. Okay, this is the last eyeshadow palette that I'm going to talk about. I actually put this back in the box. This palette was sent to me from ZZ. I'm pretty sure I'm saying that correctly. If not, I do apologize. This is the British Museum in ZZ, and this is the Alice in Wonderland Off With Their Heads palette. So you have this beautiful palette. Now, I did not review this here on my YouTube channel, but I have an Instagram video up where I'm showing you close-ups of this palette. I'm showing you swatches and a tutorial. And I have to say, there are some shades in this palette that are amazing. This one, and this one. So I would say three, possibly four, but really three of these shades are amazing, like beautiful, shimmery, like really heavy. It's not glitter, but it has that glittery, shiny, kind of wet look that I love. Now, this is kind of, it's a palette I'm going to keep more for the packaging. I'm not going to reach for this a ton. These matte shades, there's mostly mattes. This pressed glitter, I hate. I'm not even going to talk about that. The brush is okay. But the matte shades right here are just, they're okay. They're good. They're not great. It's definitely usable. This Color Story doesn't call to me a ton. They do have a pink palette and they have a blue palette that I would really love to try. But I think this is really, really beautiful packaging. Three of the shadows inside are amazing and the rest of the shades are just good shades. If you see this and you like this packaging and you think it's as beautiful as I do, I think you'll be happy with your purchase. I'm going to keep it in my collection because I love it. I think, like, I love the packaging. The shadows inside, I'm just going to be honest, I don't think I'm going to reach for this palette anymore. It's not great enough to make me want to pull it out of my collection. But if you do want to see a tutorial, I have it up on my Instagram. And I'm really considering buying the other two palettes, the pink and the blue, because I want to test it out and I want to see if maybe I would enjoy this more in a different color story. This color story just didn't call to me as much as the other two do. Okay, along with that, Palace Identity is the sister brand to ZZ. They sent me a couple of other things I wanted to follow up on. The first is this contour powder. Now, I used this in a video, and contour just isn't my thing. Like, look at my face. I'm a chubby little cheeked chipmunk over here looking like a bullfrog. You can't contour this, okay? I like to use bronzer to sculpt my face and add some warmth. So I tried this as a contour. In that video, I was even like, you know what? Contour doesn't work for me. Let me try to use this as a bronzer. And it looked okay. It definitely looked okay. But the packaging is so beautiful. The compact is so beautiful. I don't want to get rid of this, but I don't want to use this on my face. It just doesn't, it's not how I like to look, but it's so beautiful. Now they make a blush like this that has the same imprint. I may buy the blush just because this is so pretty, but I will probably end up passing this along to a friend who likes a cool toned contour, because that's definitely what this is. Even the shade is called Classic Gray Brown, and that just does not work for my warm olive undertone. Okay, also from Palace Identity, I have this. Oh my gosh, this is the most beautiful lipstick I've ever seen in my life. It has a dragon. They sent me the shade M13. This is the Dragon Velvet lipstick, and this is one of my favorite lipsticks. This is a very beautiful creamy lipstick. It says it's a velvet lipstick, and that's exactly what it is. It's not shiny, it's not matte, it's just that classic lipstick. The shade they sent me, beautiful. The packaging, amazing. It's a magnetic closure. Like, I love this. I have not put this away. Like, it's not going in a drawer. It has been sitting in front of me on my desk so I can see it. I love dragons. I love mythology. I love stories, legends, all of that. So this is just so beautiful. It makes me so happy to see her like crawling up the lipstick. I just absolutely love it. If I could recommend you anything from ZZ, Palace Identity, like this lipstick instantly makes me happy. Okay, let's talk about a few complexion products that I purchased. I bought the Dior Forever Skin Glow Foundation. Now, I found it pretty hard to shade match online. I can usually get my shade right online, but I have to say, this shade I actually thought was going to be too dark for me. This is 3WO, so 3 Warm Olive, but it's very light on me. When I first came back from the beach, it was extremely light on me. I went on a family vacation earlier this month, and it was definitely too light for me. But I feel like this is going to be a perfect winter shade, and I'm wearing it today. I am wearing it today with a little bit of bronzer. I can make it work, but I think it's going to be a perfect winter shade. Now, this says it is 24-hour wear, radiant perfection, skin-caring foundation with sunscreen, lasting hydration, SPF 35, which, you know, foundation with SPF, it's better than nothing, but still wear your sunscreen underneath. This is a glowy foundation. For me, this is a medium coverage glowy foundation. I am 34 years old. I have oily skin, but look at me. I love to glow. I embrace my oily skin. I love it. So I wanted the Skin Glow Foundation, and I have to say, I really like this. My foundation right now has only been on for about an hour. I'm loving it. Of course, I have highlight, everything like that on, but I love the natural glow that it gives my skin. I do make sure, well, with any foundation ever, I always set with powder. I would say when I use this, I use just a little bit extra powder, especially here where I tend to get the oiliest. And I would say at about hour 10 of wearing this, I do feel like, okay, maybe I need to like blot my skin, or maybe I need to touch up with a little bit of powder. I don't always do that because who has time to do that? So I have definitely worn this 12 to 14 hours, but I feel like it wears the best for like up until the 10 hour point. At the 10 hour point, I want to do a little touch up, but it still continues to look good. I really enjoy this foundation. I've been reaching for it a ton, and I would definitely say this is a favorite. I also found a great new concealer, which I love. I love concealer. I love trying new concealers, but they don't always work for my oily skin because I put my concealer under my eyes. Y'all heard me when I said I am 34, I am a mom, I work in the hospital. Listen, I'm always busy. I need something that's going to cover and make me look like I've slept more than 4 hours, you know? So a lot of concealers just don't work for me, and my oily skin eats them. But I have this, the Anastasia Beverly Hills Magic Touch Concealer is good, y'all. This is a medium to full coverage concealer, depending on how much you use. You want medium coverage, just a little less. You want full coverage, a little more. My oily skin does not break it apart. I feel like I look blurred and smooth. It's a very natural finish. It's not matte. It's not glowy. It sits there right in the middle to where you're not like mattified, but you're not like, wow, she's dewy glowy, which you know I love both. I love to be matte. I love to be glowy. This is a very natural looking concealer. Huge doe foot. Huge doe foot. You get a lot of product in here too. You get 12 mls, which I feel like is a lot. The big doe foot I love because that means I'm not dipping back and forth, like wasting time. I can like get my concealer on with one dip in here. Like, I really enjoy this. This concealer needs more hype. It really deserves more hype. I've been reaching for it a ton. Okay, I recently got sent some Charlotte Tilbury brow products from Octoly. Octoly is like a review site. So I got sent these and I did an Instagram tutorial with these if you want to see my brows. All right, let me just say before I talk about these products individually, I will not repurchase these. These are expensive. These are expensive. I love my Morphe Micro Brow Pencil. It's tiny. I love my NYX Brow Pen. And I love my NYX Brow Glue. I love my Pink Honey. Listen, when it comes to brows, I'm more of a budget-friendly type of person. But let's talk about these. Let's talk about these individually. If you're like, you know what, Heather, I don't care. I want luxury brow products. I have the review for you. This is the Brow Lift Brow Pencil. Okay, this is big, but I know some of y'all like these big type of brow. Like, this is like the ABH Brow Definer, I guess. I'm holding it up to my face so you can see how big it is compared to my brow. It has a spoolie on one end. The packaging does not feel luxurious on this one. The packaging feels like my Morphe or my NYX, okay? So this is big. I got the color, what did I get? Natural black. I can make it work. It's hard for me to get the brow I like with this big brow. Like, it's large, okay? So if you have really fluffy brows and you're like, I like something large to just, like, lightly fill, then this may be for you, okay? I don't think the packaging feels super luxurious. I'm actually probably going to give this to my sister-in-law because she does. She likes this shape. Not necessarily for me, but it's good. It's good. I'm not saying it's bad. It's just, like, for me, I'll stick with the budget friendly. Now, this is the Brow Cheat Micro Precision Brow Pencil. All the natural black again. This feels luxurious. I don't know why they did like this plasticky packaging for this one and then this luxurious like rose gold packaging. This feels heavy. It feels nice. Again, you have a spoolie on one end. This is what I use today in combination with my NYX brow pen. This is smaller. See, it's much smaller, but it's still kind of that like triangle type of shape where I like a micro brow. They said micro precision brow here. It's not micro enough. The Morphe is smaller. The Urban Decay brow blade is smaller. This is still a little bit bigger. Again, I have close-ups and a tutorial on my Instagram if you want to see it in action, but it's good. I'll use this up. I used this today. I will use this up. I will use it completely up, but I won't be repurchasing it. I just don't need it. Okay. Next up, I have the Legendary Brows Micro Precision Tinted Brow Gel. Now, this is, if you just want a little bit of hold, a little bit of tint, this is for you. This is a tiny thing. It is colored, and it's just going to give you a little color and a tiny bit of hold to your brows. Very nice. I think for me, I'm going to keep using the e.l.f. Brow Wow when I want something like this. This is like $3. This is like $20-something dollars. Same type of thing, in my humble opinion. Next, we have the Brow Fix Clear Brow Gel. This is what I'm using today. This I like, this I will keep using, and I will use it up. But I have to say, this is just like the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. It's just like the one from Benefit that was just okay, that's in like the silver, I don't know. It's just like the AVH, it's just like the Benefit. It's just a good stronghold brow gel. I personally prefer like my Pink Honey, like that's really thick and really holds it down, or the NYX Brow Glue. Like, I just prefer those more. But yeah, I got sent those. I'll continue to use them, but I won't be repurchasing. So those I'm just kind of like, yeah, you're good, you're okay, you can stay, but you're not like the fave. Okay, the next few things I'm going to go through pretty quickly because I feel like I used them in videos and I talked and talked and talked and talked about them so much that y'all are like, we know you already love these. Okay, first up, the Sigma Cinderella stuff. I'll review the palette once I've tried it more. I'll put it in a palette ranking, but I have to go with this cheek duo I love. I am wearing the blush today. I think this is beautiful. All the brushes in that set, I did buy the full collection. I have two tutorials up, one on YouTube, one on Instagram. I think the Sigma blushes are amazing. The brushes are amazing. The highlight, beautiful. Same thing with the lip duo. I did purchase the Cinderella collection on my own. I bought the full collection. I love the lip duo. I've been reaching for it so much. Like, y'all are probably sick of seeing me wear it. And then Sigma actually sent me their Glow Kissed highlighter palette. They did not send me the Cinderella, but they did send me a couple of things, and their Glow Kissed highlighter palette is one of the things they sent me. I love this. I took this on my vacation with me. This is a beautiful, beautiful formula. I do have a video swatching and using this. It's so beautiful. The way it sits on the skin is amazing. I think this will work for a lot of different skin tones, but if you're like, you know what, I don't want a whole highlight palette, check out the cheek duo, because you do get a highlighter in here, and I think it's beautiful. These I'm gonna keep using like they're going out of style. Next up, I have some ColourPop Tinkerbell stuff to share with y'all. Again, the palette will be in a later video doing a ranking, but I wanted to quickly touch on this because I've already tried these formulas before, so I kind of already knew my thoughts. The Super Shock Cheek formulas, both of the blushes, love so much. The Super Shock Cheek formula is some of my favorite cheek formulas in the world. Like, I love them. So the highlighter I love, this is the highlighter that I'm wearing today. It's ColourPop Tinkerbell Happy Thoughts Super Shock Cheek. The two blushes I absolutely love so much. Same thing with the Super Shock eyeshadows. I loved the colors. I think they're so beautiful. I've worn all three of these on my eyes. I've worn them all in videos, I'm pretty sure, and they're so pretty. Again, it's not a new formula to me, just new colors. I also have the eyeliners. Now, the eyeliners from Tinkerbell are okay. They're not great. If you're thinking about purchasing these, wondering how they are, they're good, not great. I do have the green one on Fly With Me cream gel pencil in the lower waterline, and they're okay. I'll use them. I don't love them. I do think the ColourPop liners, they're not all created equal. The ones from the Hocus Pocus collection from last year are really good. These are the Twist Up pencils. I like this formula a lot better than I like this, but I'll keep them in my collection. I'll keep using them. And the same with the lip. This, listen, I know so many of y'all like the glossy lip stain. I think it's okay. It's not my favorite lip formula. I'm gonna keep using them. These are very pretty colors that came in the Tinkerbell collection. I also have one that came in the Cherry collection they did that's more like a red. These colors are colors that I will use very often. These are very pretty, but the formula is just that. It's a glossy lip stain. It's kind of like a semi-sheer. It's not sheer, but it's like not full coverage lip color with a gloss that kind of stains your lip. It's good. I like it. It's just not the fave. Also from ColourPop, I bought their Super Shock highlighters in You Got Mail and Still Loading. Love these. I've been wearing these like crazy. Again, they're a fave. The Super Shock Cheek formula is a favorite of mine. So I've been using these like crazy. Look at that. It's so pretty. If you like cream highlighters, or cream blushes, get the Super Shock Cheek Formula. They're so beautiful. I love them. I've also used these as like blush or blush toppers. I think they're so incredibly beautiful. I recently made an order from Dose of Colors. They were having a sale. I love the Dose of Colors concealer and sponge. So I think it was like 30 or 40% off. So I picked that up, and they also had the Disney collab stuff on sale. What was this? The Donald and Daisy Duck. So I got the lip liner. It doesn't have a shade on here. It just says Disney. Okay. Well, I got the lip liner. It's very nude. I like it. I think this is my first time trying a Dose of Colors lip liner. Really like it. I knew I loved the Dose of Colors lip gloss. I have so many. They're definitely such a good formula that I love. So I picked up the gloss. This is in the shade Daisy Duck. I am wearing this gloss over a liquid lip today. I don't think I ever talked about this on my channel, but I really enjoy Dose of Colors, and I'm really happy I picked these up. I'm definitely going to keep these out on my desk in front of me so I can keep using them. I would say the gloss is a favorite. I already knew I liked the Dose of Colors formula, and I really like that color. Okay, the liquid lip I'm wearing today is the Cloud Lip Clay from Kaleidos. This is the shade Terra, and I put the gloss on over top of it. So Kaleidos had sent me some of their lip clays before, and they had sent me like their blue and their really hot pink, and I just wasn't really into them. They sent me some more of like nudes, earthy tones, like this orangey color, and I really like them very, very much. They're definitely a new favorite for me. I'm so glad Kaleidos sent me some more colors to try. I love this lip color, especially with this green eye and this yellow shirt. Like, I'm just feeling the fall vibes. I really like the Cloud Lip Clays now that I have colors that I get a lot of use out of. Let me know, do you want to see a lip swatch video on Instagram? I've seen a couple of my friends, like Linda from Glitter Fallout, Angie from Angelica Nikvis. They have done lip swatch videos on their Instagram, which are really fun. So if you want me to do that, please let me know. The last thing I want to update y'all on is this P. Louise Mitchell Acid Rain Blank Canvas. So this is not like the P. Louise base, okay? This is kind of liquidy for me. I used to love it, and then I was like, I don't like it. I like this. This is my new second favorite eye base. It does not beat out MAC Paint Pot. It doesn't. MAC Paint Pot, I've probably been through 10 of these in my lifetime, like emptied them out completely. I'm in the shade Laying Low. This shade right here, I don't know if this comes in other shades. When I bought this on the Morphe site, I could only find one shade. They have so many different products. It's hard to tell like what's what. But this is the Mama Mitchell Acid Rain Blank Canvas. It's very light, but I like this. I have oily eyelids. I do not like liquidy eye bases. Like the Gerard Cosmetics wasn't a fave. The original P. Louise, not the fave. I like something that's a little thicker so that my oily eyelids don't eat through. I also have deep set eyes. Like y'all can see. Y'all are like, yeah, girl, we know. They're deep set eyes. So I have to have a good eyeshadow base or my eyes will eat eyeshadow and crease it up like crazy with these folds I have in my eyes. And I really like this. I find myself alternating between this and the Paint Pot a lot. This is a lot lighter. So if you're like, I want something super, well, I guess it depends on your skin tone. On my skin tone, this is very light, so it helps eyeshadows pop a lot. All right, y'all, I really hope you enjoyed this favorites and hate its video. We definitely have products all over the spectrum, from really bad to really amazing and everywhere in between. Make sure you're subscribed, because I use these Alien Cosmetics brushes today. I'm really enjoying those. I'll definitely keep you updated. I'm definitely gonna have a palette video coming soon. I mean, I have been testing new things. I'm looking around, I'm like, I have a lot of things. I have this Giorgio Armani foundation that I'm still in the process of reviewing. I almost have my full thoughts, but I decided to save it for next month's video. Thank y'all so much for watching. I will see you very soon in another video. Bye.